Hello, everyone.
Hi.
So I understand that there are two groups of students over here, who are undergrads. You're from China, Shanghai Institute of Technology. Can you show of hands from Shanghai Institute of Technology? So far, I Okay, great. So the rest of them, I guess you're from Singapore Institute of Technology, so both SIT, right? Okay, now I'm going to use some Chinese term. For those that don't understand Chinese term, please ask me on this side, okay? Okay. Today I'm here to actually share the entrepreneurial path that I've made out, that I've walked over the past 18 years. To tell you very frankly, I think maybe before I go there, right, let me tell you a bit more about China. In fact, I've been traveling to China quite frequently because of my work and because of the association. I'm also part of the Global Chinese Marketing Federation, which is supported by the CCPIT, which is the China Council for Promotion of International Trade. In Chinese, Mao Zhuwei. So you have Mao Zhuwei in Beijing. It's actually in Beijing itself. So over there, that's where we actually have a lot of exchange in terms of what is going on in China and what's going on in the rest of the world and what's being needed in China itself, and plus what China is able to offer to the world. So we have this platform that we promote cross-collaboration between Singapore and China. In fact, just 2 days ago, if you were to read from the news itself, Tongsan Zhongguo Business China, which is a Singapore association set up by our founding father, Lee Kuan Yew, we were here together with the governor, Shen Zhang of Guangzhou, talking about the Sino-Singapore Guangzhou Knowledge City. So China is actually growing up. Whatever presentation that your peer that were presenting just now, I think it's very important information that we as Singaporean or we as Singaporean entrepreneur to be needs to be aware, because China is where the next big economy, the second world will be soon first. So this is where you are able to exchange your contacts more than very well, so that when you are in China, these are all your network that you'll be using. Now, as an entrepreneur itself, we are always looking for a good networking opportunity. So this is how we widen our network. Okay, my entrepreneur path, I started 3 years ago. When I defined that, you know, there is a need in the market for events. Now, my background is actually in marketing itself, but before that, I served as a civil servant for about 7 years. Okay, and just not to burden my family, I decided to drop out of school at 16 and I went into civil service. So that's where I continued to pick up in terms of education and work at a different level. I started from the very low rank in the society as a delivery man. So I did delivery for about 1.5 years. But when I was doing delivery itself, it's also when I picked up entrepreneurial skills from my bosses. Now, I was doing delivery for a company that deals with Chinese patent medicines, Zhongcheng Dao. So that's where I picked up Chinese and I picked up marketing skills and selling skills. So whichever level you are at right now or you are in, you look for opportunities to continue to learn. Okay? Back to China. Show of hands, Singaporean SIT students, where you put up hands. Okay, can you take out something from your back pocket, your wallet? Do you have wallets in Singapore? Students, you have your wallet, right? You have your wallet, right? Just show your wallet. You know what happened to me when I was in Shanghai? I was in Shanghai a couple of months, right? You have your wallet, right? You see how big your wallet is? Can I have a look at your wallet? How much you want? Okay, okay. So Chinese students, you know, from Shanghai, do you carry wallet nowadays? You do, right? But not that thing, right? Oh, in fact, there are a lot of them that doesn't carry wallet. Thanks. Thank you, sir. That's what happened to me. So while I was in China itself, while I was in Shanghai, Beijing, Guangzhou, what happened was I was carrying a lot of cash, wallets, cash in my wallets itself. And I thought that, you know, in fact, all over in China itself, we are using WePay, using Zhuangwanzhan. So that's where I started to realize that, hey, you know how backward we are, Singaporeans, who still carry wallets with me. I carry two, one big one for foreign currency and one with my ID itself. So I think as entrepreneur, you need to look out for all this technology. What is going on in the world itself? You will find that we are very backward when it comes to things like payment gateway. You know, we are talking about PayLah right now. China started replaying like 3-4 years ago. In fact, you can be looking at the small little stall. I went to this coffee place at Beijing. Small little stall, and they no longer accept cash. They are asking to use WePay. And we Singaporeans, we have a problem because you know we don't have a 中国账号. So that's where I started to download and I pay my friend cash so that I don't look like an idiot paying cash. I pay my China counterpart, I pay in US dollars and say, hey, it's WhatsApp people. You send me some of the money so that I can use it. But now we check. Okay? So now, as Singaporean, I think we need to be more open-minded. We may not be what we were last time. 四小龙, remember we were four dragons last time. Okay? But where are the four dragons right now? Take a look at Hong Kong. Where are they? Okay? So I think we should be learning more from our counterpart from China itself. And that's where the exchange program is important. And likewise, for those coming from China, from Shanghai itself, right? I think there are a lot of things that you can pick up. One thing is your language. Now, if you can see the way that that you're presenting right now, good, right? You can speak proper English. But the thing is that if you come to this part of the world, it may be different. So I think in terms of exchange program, that's where you learn from each other, languages and skills and knowledge, okay? Since I'm here to talk about entrepreneur, maybe I'll share with you what actually makes an entrepreneur in my own interpretation. I think being an entrepreneur, 创业者, 最主要的, the most important thing. If I speak Chinese and you don't know us, the person beside you, you're not behind you. It's time that we need to pick up the second language or the third language right now. Most important thing, I think, is passion, right? I think being passionate about everything that you do, that sets the pace for you or sets the path for you towards success. Okay, so being passionate about something, like take for example, so may I ask you, is it Singapore? Yeah. From Singapore, okay. So what kind of sports do you do?
Swimming, right?
Okay, today, if your friend were to ask you to go for swimming, say that around 8 a.m., is it okay with you? Do you like need to make excuses not to go swimming? No, right? Because you know why? Passion. Because that's his hobby, passion. So I don't have to force you to go for swimming or to date you for swimming, swim sessions. So things like that. How to actually make your job into a passion? This is the utmost important. How can you actually transform yourself? Thinking that your job is actually your passion. Because if it's your passion, right? That's the number one, right? It's play, right? It's a hobby. So for my industries, we are known to work very hard, work 7 days a week. In fact, for the Tong Sang for Business Channel, we work 48 hours without sleeping. We went through everything before. Then again, you ask me, do I enjoy it? In fact, yes, I do. I learn from it. Every event, we learn something new. So passion is one thing. Second thing, enthusiasm. I think being enthusiastic, sometimes don't mix passion and enthusiasm. Passion, you can be very passionate about something, but if you're not enthusiastic enough to pick up, to go, to really make the first step, to really make the first move itself, I think nothing happens, right? You can be liking something and yet not approaching. Take for example, if you like a guy, and you're passionate, but you don't have the enthusiasm to step forward and ask him, then nothing is going to happen, right? Correct? So you need the enthusiasm. And lastly, third but not least, not the least, is actually the integrity. In business, entrepreneur, we always talk about integrity. Okay? Because your reputation takes a long time to build. Okay, so protect your integrity itself. This is what I've got to share for now. I think the other thing is that just now I heard something very interesting from one of the presenters from China itself. That sets me to think. In fact, for entrepreneurship, it doesn't have to start forming a business, being an entrepreneur, something can start anywhere. Even today as a student. Now if, I think Professor during the competition that we had, the global brand planning competition, there were a lot of teams from China, Taiwan, including those from Singapore, and Thailand. In fact, just over 2 days ago, I was in Thailand, meeting up with the team. Do you know they actually started the business that they were presenting while they were in schools? This is something apparently quite common even in China itself. You don't have to wait upon your graduation. You can start thinking about what you want to do right now. You can start thinking what kind of business, what kind of area. Always identify in the area of business, there must be a need somewhere. And look forward towards filling that kind of need. There must be something, there must be a vacuum. There must be something out there that you find that, hey, it's not good enough. You wanted to do it, you can do better. So it's always about matching about what is needed out there and your capability. Well, just to let you know, in fact, we're talking about QR code. You know, I think the change from Chinese SIT, Shanghai Institute of Technology, you know QR code. You probably have your own personalized QR code from WeChat, right? Yeah. Everyone. What was important? You have your own QR code. You don't have right? Okay. Every one of them that has a WeChat account will have a personalized QR code. And that's where over last week, in fact, sorry, 2 days ago, when we were doing the Business China registration, we were using the QR code because we have a large pool of them that comes from China. So instead of generating for a QR code, right, we actually asked them to use your WeChat, your WePay QR code itself. And from there, we are able to capture their attendees. You know, so things like that in fact, they are thinking, for the Chinese itself, they are thinking a lot more in terms of technology. That's where you look at that as an opportunity. So what we did was we captured that because of my frequent travel to China. I started to realize that, hey, you know what? Signing in and getting a card, going through my laptop may not be the best way. So that's where we use QR code to scan them so easy. You know, I've got my colleagues behind that were helping during the event. It's so much easier. Open up your WeChat, scan, we know you're in. We know who you are. And we can always send message to you. But you know those from China, you know it's nothing new. Every day. But for Singaporean, you ask yourself, do you have your own QR code that you can actually use for your own social media itself? So that's something that perhaps you need to think. So for entrepreneurs like us, we always look for technology. Technology is the one that actually drives in terms of what is being needed out there. Last year, I was talking about VR, AR, and augmented reality, virtual reality, and MR, mixed reality itself. But this is something that is happening even in China right now. When I went over to China, when I was talking about this subject itself, I was surprised there are a few agencies in China that are picking up on this. And they are actually the younger generations in the business sector itself. So as younger generations, like you, especially when you're still studying, when you're still developing, in being innovative is actually one of the key things. So look for things like that. Even in our own company itself currently, we are no longer using what? E-invite, email invite. That's the thing in the past. I was telling my client, what do we still send? Do we still send microsites? Do we still use e-invite to your events? No, we use apps, APP. It's so much easier right now, it's on your phone, right? So that's how we pitch in to our new customers. And you know, especially in events like, you always look for new things to pitch in. You always look for new stories to tell. If you want to be an entrepreneur, you need to be a storyteller. You need to actually articulate what your ideas are. Okay? So this is one of the... Sorry, is there something that you...
Yes, I actually have a question. Can you say
it? Sure. Well, yes, be welcome. And identify yourself.
I'm a senior student in law lecture. Okay. Lecture. So this is a question that I would like to ask. Now you have talked about embracing... Big buzzword is autonomous ships, but at the end of the day, most of us, we realize that except for the smaller niche trades, we don't need autonomous ships. So how do we as millennials or youths, and as you're called, make sure that the technology that we see, we can use it from a realistic point of view?
Okay, good questions. You know which generation are you in right now? You're a millennial, or what we call Z, what we call generation A, alpha right now. Okay. Now, I think technology is something which will drive your business forward. Now, it may be new, you may be the end of time right now, but never give up on innovation, because this is something which will allow you to differentiate with your nearest competitor. So as in market itself, we are talking about sustainable competitive advantage, right? So do not give up on innovation and technology. It may be something very new. In fact, to tell you frankly, VR, AR, it's nothing new. It existed in the 1980s. But why is it picking up right now? It's because of all these devices, the phones, your iPad that's easily available right now. Now, you talk about VR itself, it existed in the 1980s. In fact, I've seen my first VR was in 1991, while I was actually handling an event together with Huawei. They were showing me, okay, you take up your phone, and then you look at certain directions, you can see all the icons appearing at a certain distance and whatever. Same, you know, I was like you. Sorry, I didn't get your name, sir.
Most,
right? I was like you, I was like, so what has it got to do? What is so innovative about this? We don't know how to use it. But look at today. Today, in today's context itself, VR and AR is something that's what very real. It's being needed right now, especially with devices. So don't be a myopic like me. I was then embrace technology and at the same time try to look. You may not be the right time right now, but do not give up on innovation. Because this is something which will drive your business forward and give you the competitive edge you need.
Well, I'm thinking that if you want to do some marketing, when you want to do the new technology push for a sake of doing it.
Okay. Good questions. Now marketing, people are always asking something. Well, marketing is something like very far, very deep subject. Let me ask you something. If you were to realize, right? You know, you've been to hawker stores, Xiaohanzhongxing, for those in Chinese. Xiaohanzhongxing, you saw hawker stores? You saw, you went there, right? You know, that guy probably has not gone through marketing, but he's really doing marketing. You see the signage, signboard, his pictures, and all sorts of things. Okay, so when you're talking about marketing, you're talking about something that is
something very new,
right? Okay, the moment you should do marketing, you something very new. You started to do something about marketing, about something very old, right? Then there isn't very much a story to pitch. Remember, all marketers were all story pitching. Alright? So, if something that's very new, it depends on how you want your audience to actually understand and adopt what you want to say. Okay? The more that you should do marketing, especially when it comes to like something that's very innovative, something that's very new in the market itself. Let me ask you something. Today, you want me to tell you stories about the Sleeping Beauty and the... You know what, right? So, a story tells what I need. What do I need to tell you? Something that's very new, right? Something that's very new in the market. Something that's new stories.
My concern is, I start this new trend, and then somebody follow me for the sake of following.
Good question again. You know, I teach events management, and I own an events management company. And when I teach events management, I always showcase what is going on. I always showcase what I've been doing, you know? So it's about sharing. You know, I've got my class attendees that will ask me, hey, Roger, but you show what you are doing right now for your clients and are your competitor. So is there a reason why you're doing so? I always tell them one thing. Showing you up is one thing, and doing it is another. I can show you, but whether are you able to execute it, that's another thing altogether. Now, the other thing. Yes.
I'm fine, I'm fine, I'm fine. I'll just finish this last sentence. For the...
Okay, like what I said, okay, I'm finishing just last sentence. Showing you is only one thing, knowing it is one thing, showing you, but able to execute is another. One last sentence. If I show you, you know how to do it, it actually sets me to what? To go on to the next level of what implementing something new. Alright, so that gets me to the end of my game. I can be telling you something that I'm doing right now, but I'm already thinking about what to do next year or the next 4 years. So we can set the pace apart. That's what we call sustainable advantage. Alright, thank you. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.